Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. heavens. We know, Father, that the joy that they have is perhaps even a pale reflection of the kind of joy that there is in heaven. We cannot help but remember the presence of the Lord Jesus at the marriage feast in Cana of Galilee, and by your presence, you hallowed and sanctified that occasion. We know, O Lord, that you are present here, and we thank you that you not only appear in this room in a very real way, but that you are present in the lives of these young people. You brought them together, and we know, Lord, that you have great things in store for them. And so we thank you for what you will do and for the joy that is in our hearts on this occasion. And we pray these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. For where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be still. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I'm fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love.
Special, scripted word. You two on a special day, a special occasion.
Stephen and Jennifer would like us to do with their union in heart, body, and mind is God's plan for them, for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given to each other, in prosperity and adversity, for richer or for poorer. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but soberly, deliberately, and in reverent fear before God.
For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is head of the church, his body of which he is the Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing of water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle, or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, just as Christ did the church, for we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one in flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I'm talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband.
Es ist diese Liebe, das Gott will für euch heute in der Erde. Seine Liebe garantiert euch etwas Wunderbares. Mit Gott zuerst und miteinander. Seine Liebe ist das Fundament eurer persönlichen Beziehung mit Gott durch Jesus Christus. Jetzt soll seine Liebe das Fundament sein für eure Ehe. Gott hat uns alles geschenkt durch Jesus Christus. Die wirkliche Freiheit, die Möglichkeit, in Freiheit zu leben und auch die Möglichkeit, mit Gott zu sein in Ewigkeit. Seine Liebe hört niemals auf. Niemals. God's love is the most important element in your marriage other than your personal relationship with Jesus Christ. His love which never fails, as we heard Matt sharing with us from 1 Corinthians 13. A love which is eternal, beginning not just today, but has begun and will always be. Each day unchanging in its commitment. This love, God's love, is unconditional. Isn't that wonderful? Unconditional love in the marriage, in the relationship. Unconditional. It does not seek its own, as we read in 1 Corinthians 13, and the relationship is not boastful.
wonderful promises of what love is for us today and for you too, as you walk together in Him. It does not pay back wrong for wrong. God's love does not rely on feelings, but it is a commitment in marriage, which you are doing today before us all. If your love is based on feelings, then your love will be conditional rather than unconditional. But God teaches us differently about love, differently than man teaches. He gave us Jesus as a perfect example. Jesus' love for us is unconditional, as we read in the scriptures. Irregardless of who we are, what we are, or even what we were in the past, it is unconditional. He loves us unconditionally. He gave His life for us and for our sins, the sacrifice of love. Unconditional love is sacrificial and will be sacrificial in the marriage relationship. It is a priceless love, Stephen and Jennifer. A love not seeking its own welfare, but the welfare of others, and in your case, of each other. Matthew read to us one of the most important passages in the scriptures concerning love. Love for each one of us here, and love for you too, in your long life together. This is the chapter which describes for you and for us the love that God has for us through Jesus Christ, as well as the love that you should seek daily in your marriage, every single day, His love, with Him and with each other. And the scriptures tell us the first step in being able to love one another, Stephen for you to love Jennifer, and let Jennifer for you to love Stephen, unconditionally, is to love God first. You love God first, it will be possible to love one another unconditionally. You'll be committed to one another. You'll be best friends. You'll be very happy together. Stephen and Jennifer, this is to be the foundation of your marriage, His love. You have made His love the foundation of your lives. Now it is to be a part of your marriage. This is the true meaning of the two will become one flesh. In His love. You will be able to experience His love each and every day, personally, and in your marriage. This love which never fails will never fail you. In Christ Jesus, you will never be disappointed. Please keep that in your hearts as you walk together, but that is what God offers you today and for each one of us. Love unconditional. Stephen and Jennifer, build your home on the foundation of Jesus Christ. Living with God, you will have everything that you need, everything, both spiritually and physically, everything. Jetzt haben wir den Teil der Ehe. Now will you please express your vows of love and devotion, this love that God has given, to each other. Jennifer, I am here to become one with you.
I am here to become one with you.
In front of our family,
in front of our family,
friends and maker,
friends and maker,
I promise to lead you,
I promise to lead you,
and help you,
and help you,
through the rocky and winding road of life.
Through the rocky and winding road of life.
I will love you,
I will love you,
until our maker calls us. Jennifer, would you please share that for me? I think you'd like to share with Stephen today. Stephen? Today I come to join my life to yours.
Today I come to join my life to yours.
In the presence of our Lord.
In the presence of our Lord.
And our family and friends.
And our family and friends.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
To respect you.
To respect you.
And to grow with you for the rest of my life. Through the years that pass, prosperity may smile at us. Trials may come. But no matter what we encounter, it will be together. I will make my home with you. I vow to love you and honor you until death separates us. Would you please
Repeat this after me. As you put it in the Bible. To remind us.
To remind us.
Of my promise to you.
Of my promise to you.
To be a faithful and loving husband.
To be a faithful and loving husband.
Jennifer, please repeat after me. Stephen. I give you this ring as a reminder of my promise to you to be a faithful and loving wife.
Thank you. Getränke sind draußen vorhanden. Falls jemand auf das Schiff möchte, es wird um 3 Uhr den Hafen verlassen. Also viel Spaß und man sieht sich vielleicht später.
And also, sit still for 1 minute for the photographer.
Gonna be.
Ha ha ha.
Billy, can you blow bubbles?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can blow bubbles.
See y'all on the boat.
Yeah.
All right, see ya.
Thank you. So you go up on, we can go up on the next level. It's like a step up system.
Next level?
Yeah.
I can't hear that.
I can't explain it.
Thank you.
another one of these.
I am necessary to cutting the cake.
Oh, hey, breakfast.
Okay.
Uh-oh, watch out.
Yeah.
Take it out of the room.
I want to take some time on this tasting, but this is something for Heidelberg and I.
Thank you. Here we are, Steve and Jennifer's wedding, June 8th.
Oh, yeah?
2002.
Yeah, let me put the date on there.
Here, bitch. It's a beautiful day going down the Rebecca. We love ya.
Hey, Billy, those strawberries any good?
Yeah, I guess so. Release essence.
Hello, Bill.
Hello.
How you doing? Woo!
Good.
Hey, Jim boy.
Hello.
Jim Bob.
No, it says no voting.
So what's happening? So what's happening? What's happening here, Bill?
It
smells. It is huge. We're gonna go up another level. Oh yeah, we're going up. No. Nope. Bill, what's happening here?
What?
What are we here for?
You're recording?
No, why is this boat here? Are we going up again?
No, it's gotta go down now. Oh. We're going down into a lower level.
Oh, okay.
Excuse me.
Hello. Having a good time?
Oh yes. This is the first time I've been on one of these boats.
Yeah. Me too, just the one going to Canada.
Yeah, so how you doing there? You zoomed up on my eyeball or something?
No, just a face, but now I can go back a little bit.
Yay.
What are those fumes?
Where?
No, did you smell them?
Oh, yeah, diesel.
Mmm.
Diesel fumes.
Oh boy. The boat is going up. I didn't know that they did this to the boats.
Hey, did you do a well-wishing on the video?
Yeah, I did. Did you?
Yeah, what'd you say? What'd you do?
It was pretty dumb. I couldn't think what I said, and I said, Stephen, Jennifer, I think I said, good luck on your marriage, and don't fight too much. It's pretty bad. Couldn't think of what to say. What should I have said?
I don't know. Whatever, ad lib. I said something to the effect that, you know, I hope you have as many happy years in your marriage as I have our 15 years, you know?
Well, that 15? We've been married almost 18. Our son is 17.
let me go put that.
Maybe you mean only 15 were happy. Here she comes, walking down the street.
Yeah.
Here I am. 1, 2, 3, go. Hi.
Hi, Marilyn.
Hi, how you doing?
Well, fine. This ought to be a great video when they're done. When we're done.
Very interesting. Name?
Katie.
Hi, Katie. Are you 8 or 9 or 10?
9.
Well, bye, Katie. Bye. What's that? That kind of camera.
Hey, is the battery symbol blinking?
Yeah.
Here's another battery for
us. Right now?
Yeah.
But I want to get this though.
Boy, you can feel free to hold it here to help steady it.
Are we turning?
No, we are going that down that way. We are curving.
Ooh, I can live over there, Bill.
You want to get it on video?
Grab a live there.
Zoom in on it?
Yeah. Zoom in on the lady in the shower. No.
We were married close to 18 years, so that just goes to show you have a good marriage. Time goes by.
Come again, my cougar, where dein Bruder ist.
Hello, guten Tag.
Okay. 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 Ok
He wants to let you know that he took a picture of the cake.
That's
a good? Yeah, that's a good thing, Where is the single guy?
Yeah.
got a nice comfortable ride there.
Take care, Cozy.
Thank you, Bill. Have a good evening.
Hey, look, our first windmill. Take a right over here. Something third me. Something like that. I've never seen a windmill before in real life.
Yeah, it makes me kind of tired. Oh, it's because you're
Yeah, this used to be a border checkpoint. May
your
I see your papers?
Please.
Your papers, please.
Your papers, Peter.
Hey, mom, they got Chinese cars in America.
Yeah. I said, like, why you should let this go?
Because Chinese is Japanese.
They can find a hotel.
Look at that little ugly car.
I didn't see it. I missed it.
Thank you.
Look. Definitely gonna be docs. Camp it and mental save.
Here we are in Cleve. We came from Nijmegen yesterday. Hello.
Good morning.
Morgan. Where's Billy? Where's Billy at?
I got it.
Hi.
Morgan.
You almost ready?
Yes.
Good. Und du?
Good. You've got hip surgery.
What?
You've got hip problem.
I know. We gotta get going pretty soon. Ein hippen Problem.
Ein hippen. Ein hippen kaputt, Daddy?
No, it's not kaputt.
Thank you.
Belgium?
Yeah. Hi Billy.
Hi.
You gonna take a ferry across maybe?
Yeah.
It's on a leash.
It's getting
kinda old now. I think it's a match monkey. You gotta pay the one, man. Probably. See the man in front of you? Guy in the sky, he's walking around with his damn powder. I'm going now. You can eat us.
Yeah.
You know what this crazy one is.
It's the Liberté, Égalité, Liberté, Égalité, Tinté.
Cemetery, Milité?
Yeah, something like that.
I'm